Hi there, my name is Scott Westover, and welcome to my course on Introduction to GitHub Actions. In this mini course, you'll be learning about GitHub Actions and GitHub Workflows. The goal of this course is to provide you a brief introduction to GitHub Actions, how they function, and why you should care about GitHub Actions. Throughout the course, you'll be introduced to various CI/CD workflows that you can take and use on a daily basis. In this course, we will be covering the following topics. We'll be going over GitHub workflows and actions. We'll be covering what these terms mean, how the GitHub Actions platform can be used to improve your CI/CD workflows, the core concepts of GitHub Actions. We'll be going over the workflow files and what the syntax of these workflow files is in these YAML files, how GitHub uses these files to run your various workflows, and the directory it expects those files to be in for everything to function. We'll be doing a brief project setup so you can follow along with the code in this course. We'll be taking a look at the GitHub Actions Marketplace and how you can search for other actions to reuse in your workflows. We will be taking a look at how we can create our own workflows, such as integration test, tagging and versioning a project on GitHub, publishing an NPM package, pull request workflows for linting, testing, and building your application code. And we'll be looking at the various triggers that we can use to trigger these types of workflows, and we'll be providing you the code and reviewing how they all function. For this course, we have the following basic requirements. It is required that you'll have a GitHub account. This is required for using GitHub Actions and for creating repositories, both public and private, in GitHub. It can be a free account. There's no charge. You don't need to have a paid account to follow along with this course. You will need to have some background knowledge in Git. This course will not be covering what Git is, what Git flows are, how to set up Git, etc. The course already assumes that you have some of this knowledge. Finally, you're going to need a text editor or an IDE for editing the course files. This could be any editor you choose, such as IntelliJ, WebStorm, Notepad, Notepad++, VS Code, etc. And finally, for this course, I will be using VS Code as my IDE. This is not a requirement for this course, but here's a link in case you need an editor and would like to try out VS Code. All right, let's get started.